So what would daylight saving time look like if it stayed permanent here in Maryland? Let's check in with Ava Marie. And I guess, Ava, we should start at the very beginning. Why did we start, you know, springing forward and falling back in the first place?
You know, I think everyone asks that every year when we switch the clocks, because it can be so hard on our sleep schedules and on our family schedules. So why do we even have daylight saving time? Well, it should be called daylight shifting time, because you can't actually create more sunlight, but you can shift it. So this started as a way throughout the last century in order to save energy. Now, it's debatable whether or not it can actually save energy, but it does give us more daylight in the evening hours, especially during the summer months. But we've always shifted back to standard time during the winter, during the darker times of the year. So what's going to happen if we make daylight saving time permanent all year long? Well, you'll get to keep your long summer evenings, which I know will make a lot of people happy. And that means the sun is going to be up and it's going to be bright out through about 8 and 9 o'clock in the summer months. One thing you'll notice that's different too, you'll get slightly later winter sunsets. It actually will stay alight through about 5 o'clock, not getting dark till about 6 p.m. And that's good news for people who always complain about never seeing any daylight during the winter months. They go to work and it's dark, they come home and it's dark. At least now, if you get off work by about 4 and 5 p.m., you are going to have a little bit of daylight before it sets in the winter. What's going to be really tough is the winter mornings. Those already are dark and cold, and they're just going to be darker as we switch to permanent daylight saving time, because it will actually stay dark through about 8 o'clock in the morning during those tough months of January and February. So really, people have to think about, is that the trade-off they want to have? And I think it depends on where you live, because it really makes a big difference where you are in the time zone from west to east, but also where you are in the country from south to the north. A place like Florida, it doesn't make as much of a difference because they're farther south, closer to the equator. They don't see as much of a difference in their sun angle throughout the year, but the farther you go north, you see bigger changes. So while in the winter time, if we go to permanent daylight saving time, Miami will stay dark till about 7:45 in the morning. Baltimore will stay dark till about 8 a.m. You go all the way north in some of the northern cities, places like Fargo, North Dakota, it's going to be dark to almost 9 o'clock in the morning. So you imagine that is certainly going to cause more disruptions to the start of the day, especially for the school schedules. So there may have to be some accommodations to account for those dark winter mornings. So Jason, really, this comes down to whether you're a morning person or a night person.
So let's just say people had an option, or you had a menu, had to choose between staying the way we are or making a change. What would that look like?
Well, again, it comes down to whether you want that daylight in the morning or if you want that daylight at night. So if we continue switching the clocks, if this law does not become passed, we will continue to get our long summer evenings, but then we also balance that with some daylight in the winter mornings. If we go to the new law where they make daylight saving time permanent, we'll get to keep our late summer sunsets, but you'll have to deal with some dark winter mornings. A lot of people have said, well, what if we go back to standard time? That's actually closer to our natural sleep cycles. You get brighter winter mornings, earlier summer sunsets. I imagine a lot of people would be bummed, though, when the sun is going down early in the summer months. Jason, interesting that they did try this back in the 1970s, and people were all for it at first. Within a couple years, everyone's opinion changed, and we were back to this normal switching. So it'll be interesting to see how it goes this time around.
Right, we can't please everybody. I knew you'd have the answer, though. Ava Marie, thank you, and thank you folks for joining us. That's all for this edition of 11 TV Hill. We'll see you next time.